Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we have seen what conceptually nested for loop or nested loop is all about. Now in this particular video, we are going to check it out, a program where we are going to display a multiplication table from 2 to number 10. Okay, here we are going to use multiple loops. Okay, and in each loop we are going to do some purpose.
Let's see example of nested while loop. Okay, so basically here I'm having a program which will print table starting with 2 till 10. Okay, so table of 2, 3, 4, 5 till 10 it will print. Okay, now in this case we have to identify there are two tasks. Okay, one task is what? One task is printing the table, individual table, like say table of 2. So starting with 1 till 2 tens are, starting with 2 ones are till 2 tens are, it will print something. So that is my first task. So one while loop will take care of this task. Okay, and this while loop will be the inner while loop. Okay, now this task I need to perform starting with 2, this task I need to perform till 10. That means individually I have printed a table of 2. Now I have to print the table of 3 also, 4 also, till 10. Okay, so that is another for loop which will take care, that is that it will start with 2 and it will end till 10. Okay, and inside it there will be your inner for loop. So there are two tasks which I'm performing. One is printing the table and second one is checking 2 to 10 table has to be printed. Okay, so basically here I'm starting with here. So I have variable int table of and assign value to it, that is 2. That means my starting of tables will be 2. Then I'm having while loop which is checking that it is making sure that till 10 it should execute. That's why table of has to be less than equals to 10. Then I'm having inner part of it, that is body of this loop, which is having variable int I which is initialized to 1. Then I'm having another while loop, that means this is inner loop. Okay, so this while loop is doing what? It is checking whether I value is less than equals to 10 or not. Basically this is doing the job of printing the table which is starting with 1 and end till 10, and inside it I'm just printing the table. So what is table of? Table of value starting with 2 multiply by value of I, so 2 into I, that is 1. So it will print 2 into 1, that is 2, and then it is keep on incrementing the value of I. Okay, so what is happen? What will happen? First of all, it will start with 2. It is checking whether value of 2 is less than 10. If it is less than 10, it will enter inside the value of inside the while loop. Here it is doing job of printing table of 2. So until the table of 2 is getting printed in the inner loop, what is going to happen? It will keep on incrementing the value of I. After that, what is happened? Once this particular condition becomes false, you will come out of the loop. Okay, and what will happen? It is just going to provide some space, printed the space, and then it will increment the value of table of. That means this becomes 3. And then again it is going to outer loop condition. It is checking for condition 3 less than equals to 10. Again it will enter to the while loop and it will keep on printing the table of 3. And after that, after the printing of table completed, it will again come out of the inner loop. It will complete the further processing. Again, it will check the condition and so on. Okay, so let's check it out what it does. I'm just saving it. Java C nested while dot Java. Compiled. Let's run this. Have a look what it is doing. It has printed table of 10, then 9, 8, 7. Okay, started with beginning. Yeah, table of 2, then 3, then 4. So I will say that this has been done by your inner for loop, while all these things are part of your outer loop. Okay, so how many times your outer loop has got executed? It got executed 9 times. Okay. And how many times your inner loop is got executed? It is executed 10 times. Okay. So that is one of the example of nested while loop. Okay.